our first example, we have x to the 4/5 minus 3 is equal to 13. So we need to get that term isolated that has a fractional exponent. That's going to be the x to the 4/5. So we're going to add 3 to both sides of the equation, and we get x to the 4/5 is equal to 16. Now we're going to, again, as the directions say, we're going to raise both sides of the equation by the reciprocal of that fractional or rational exponent. So we're going to raise both sides of this equation by 5/4. I got that jammed up together a little bit too much there, but that's okay. So we're going to have x to the 4/5 times 5/4. Remember, this is power to power rule. When you have stacked exponents, you do want to multiply them. And that is equal to 16 to the 5/4 power. Well, of course, these 5s and these 4s are going to cancel out, giving us that exponent of 1 that we need, effectively canceling it away. So we have x equals 16 to the 5/4 power. Now let's not forget, with fractional exponents, the top number is, once again, as I stated over here, our power, and the bottom number is our root. If you're doing these questions without the aid of a calculator, if your teacher's asking you to not use a calculator unless you just want to check your work, then you're probably going to have pretty small numbers. When you start dealing with third and fourth and fifth roots, those are the reciprocals of the third, fourth, and fifth power, and so on. And you know, when you multiply, the numbers get big very, very quickly, so it's a good chance that those numbers are relatively small. And if you're going to do a question like this, 16 to the 5/4 power, mentally, it's easier to do usually the roots first. So we have x to, or equals, let's see here, the 4th root of 16. Oh, by the way, an equivalent version of this expression would be to write the 4th root of 16 to the 5th power. But when you write it like that, it kind of makes you think that you should be doing 16 to the 5th power first and then taking the 4th root. That's going to make the numbers very, very large. And by the way, you know, we're trying to study fractional exponents, not go back and revert back to our radical format of these expressions. So again, the 4th root of 16, probably a small number. So let's try 2. 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 is 8, times 2 is, 16. So 2 to the 4th power is 16. So the 4th root of 16 is 2. So we have 2 to the 5th, and then 2 to the 5th power, well, 2 times 2 is 4, times 2 is 8, times 2 is 16, times 2, that's 5 of them, is equal to 32. And this is probably how your, you know, personal teacher is also covering these kind of problems, because they want you, you know, we're trying to teach you that, how those roots and how those powers, you know, work out, of course. If you like another way to look at this particular question, because the numbers come out, you know, to be pretty nice, you can, if you would like, sort of an alternative way of thinking your way through the answer, though, if I'm teaching roots and powers initially, this is how I would want you and my own students to do the problem. But I can write this in a bit more technical or fancy way. I can say that x is equal to 16 to the 4/4 power times 16 to the 1/4 power, where, you know, when you multiply like bases, you add the exponents, and 4 over 4 plus 1 over 4 is indeed 5/4. However, I'm just remembering here that I forgot one of my answers. Do you know what I've forgotten? What's the square root of 9? Square root of 9 is 3. Well, it's also negative 3. If the textbook puts a square root or an even root in the book for you, they are only going to be expecting you to use the positive answer, as I've done here. But if you introduce your own even root, which I effectively did by raising both sides of my equation by 5/4, that's the 4th root, and it's an even root, when you introduce your own even root, you do need to take into account that there's a positive and a negative answer, and I almost forgot that negative answer. This is actually really what I should be thinking or doing here at this step, is saying that x can be equal to, let's get that back in the white, x is equal to either positive 2 to the 5th power, which is my value of 32 that I got, and it's x is equal to negative 2 to the 5th power, because the even, I'm introducing my own even root, and the even root of 16 is either 2 or negative 2. And negative 2 to the 5th power is equal to negative 32. Whew, almost forgot that second answer for you. So here, going back to sort of this alternative way of thinking of how to get the answer, fancy way of writing 16 to the 5 fourths, well, 4 divided by 4 is 1, so this is just going to be 16. And then the fourth root of 16, again introducing our own even root, is either 2 or negative 2. So it's 16 times 2, which is 32, or 16 times negative 2, which is negative 32. So that's the end of our first example. A couple of ways to think about the final step there and getting that final values, those final values of 32 and negative 32. Let's get to our next one, our next example, that is. For our next example, we have 2y minus 6 to the 1/3 power plus 4 is equal to 7. In one way, this question is going to be a little bit easier because our powers and roots are both on, so we don't need to worry about having that positive and negative answer if we bring in our own even root. And a little bit harder because our base is not just a simple monomial, it has two terms. It's a binomial. The subtraction separates the two. The process to solve the question, though, is the same. I don't have a different set of directions for all of our questions. We're going to follow up these three steps for all of them. We're going to isolate that term with the fractional exponent, the rational exponent. We're going to do that by subtracting both sides by 4 again. And we get 2y minus 6 raised to the 1/3 power is equal to 7 minus 4, which is equal to 3. We're now going to raise both sides by the reciprocal of that rational exponent. In other words, just going to flip it. So we're going to wrap this up and raise it by a power of 3 over 1. And same thing on the right-hand side. Okay. Again, stacked exponents. That's power-to-power rule for exponents. You multiply. When you multiply reciprocals, you get an answer of 1. So our exponent is going to effectively go away. Because the power of 1, nothing changes. So we're just going to write 2y minus 6 is equal to 3 to the 3rd power. 3 times 3 is 9, times 3 is 27. We're going to subtract both sides, do the opposite of subtraction. We're going to add both sides by 6 and get 2y is equal to 33. Divide both sides by 2. And y is equal to 33 over 2, or let's see here, how about 32 divided by 2? That would be 16, so it could be equal to 16 and 1/2. Don't like decimals, so I'm not going to say it's 16.5. All right, got one more example. Okay, here we go. 2x to the negative 3/2 power equals 250. Looks kind of like the first equation, right? Actually, in a way it looks simpler than my previous two examples. There's only one term on the left and one term on the right, so I don't need to do that step to get that alone. But I do have that exponent of that is negative. So let's see what challenges that brings on. We're going to want to divide both sides by 2, completely isolating the base, which has that fractional exponent. So maybe even more so than isolating just the term, sometimes you might even want to just isolate that base that has the fractional exponent. We could deal with the 2 being there, but it'd be simpler to completely isolate the x. So we're going to divide both sides by 2. We're dividing, of course, because we want to undo that math operation of multiplication. We get x to the negative 3 over 2 power equals 125. I'm not going to do anything different just because my rational or fractional exponent is negative. I'm still going to raise both sides of the equation by the reciprocal of that fraction, which is going to be negative 2/3. Okay. These are two negative numbers. When you multiply two negative values, you get a positive answer. These are reciprocals, so we are going to, again, get an exponent of 1. So we have x to the 1st power Now, you see how this negative 3 halves? The denominator is even, so there is an even root, but our actual math work here, we're introducing an odd root, and so therefore, again, we don't need to worry about dealing with our positive and negative answer when we apply that even root, because we don't, or we have not introduced an even root. So we have 125 to the negative 2/3 power. Well, let's go ahead and get rid of that negative exponent now. Remember, to get rid of a negative exponent, you move the base. So this is going to be equal to 1/125 to the 2/3 power. When I move that base to the denominator, it allows me to change the sign of the exponent. Actually, it didn't allow me. I have to. So we end up with 1 over, doing the root first, the third root of 125. Again, it must be a small number if I'm being asked to do this on a calculator. So 2 times 2 is 4 times 2 is 8. Well, that doesn't work. 3 and 3 is 9 and 3 is 27. That doesn't work. 4 and 4 is 16. Another 4 is 64. You know I'm doing this 3 times because it is a third root, right? And then 5 times 5 is 25 times another 5 is 125. That's the number we were looking for. So the third root, the denominator, the third root of 125 is equal to 5. And then 5 squared is 25. Well, I'm at the end of my example, so I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework.